Thank you for joining us on Shine99TV.com for the 2016 Miss Clinton County and 4-H Fair Queen Pageant. Last year's winner was Lindsay Eisenhower, and she will be participating in some capacity this evening. We want to thank Clinton County Senator Brant Ershman, who's making this presentation possible on Shine99TV.com. The MC for tonight will be Shan Sheridan. And Shan Sheridan will be going to the lectern here very shortly. And there are six ladies participating this evening. Six ladies from Clinton County. And I believe all are 4-H'ers.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Clinton County Fair Queen Pageant. So, for 2016. The Fair Board is working hard to improve the fairgrounds this year. Some of the things that we're doing. Obviously, if you've seen anything in the paper or the new horse track that's being put in with the crushed limestone, it's an all-weather track. So that way we don't have to cancel harness racing like we have in the past. Like last year was a little soggy for us out here at the fairgrounds. So the carnival will be a little bit bigger this year. We got an excellent carnival coming in, and they've got a lot bigger rides. Some of the rides that they have this year are, I think there's like two rides in particular that they have. There's only two in the country. So we're pretty fortunate to have the new carnival come in town. This time it's Primetime Amusements, so we're very excited to have them this year. Some of the other things that are going on the fairgrounds, we're going to be tearing down some older structures. I think one of them's going down next Tuesday. The fire department's going to be burning down an old barn, and then hopefully next year we'll be able to replace that with a newer barn. We're also going to be doing away with some of the gravel areas that we have here. If you know anything about gravel, some of those things get washed out. So we're going to be putting millings down to make it a little bit harder surface. So that will be an excellent asset to the, want to thank Atlas Excavating for doing that for us as well. In the fall, after the fair is over, we're looking at having the grandstands sandblasted and repainted. And then we're going to start on the next project, which will be Clinton Hall and building new bathrooms and showers onto that. So we're trying to do what we can out here, what funds we have. But the Clinton County Council and the commissioners are working with us to help us make the needed improvements out here. So you will be seeing improvements over the fairgrounds this year and next year. So we hope to have a lot of those done by the spring of 2017. I look forward to seeing everyone out at the fair this year. Starting out at the fair the first night, Saturday, July 9th, we're going to be doing a fish fry and the demolition derby that will kick off the fair. And then Saturday we'll have Sunday we'll have the tractor pulls. And Monday night the carnival will actually start. So we hope that you can come out here to kick off the fair the first night for the fish fry. If you want any fish fries, it's Dan's Fish Fries doing it. Greg Smith, who's the vice president, sitting in the back row right now, he's got tickets for that and a concert that we're having on Friday. Let's see, that would be the 15th. Corey Cox, and he has tickets for those as well back here if anybody's interested in fish frying Corey Cox. I'm going to turn it over to Shan Sheridan. Once again, I wish all the contestants good luck tonight, and they look great, so it should be very exciting tonight. Shan?
Thank you, John. Appreciate it very much. Thank you. Thank you very much, John. Appreciate being here tonight, and it's always a fun time to be able to just share in not only the Clinton County Fair, but certainly the beauty and the intelligence and the personality that you're going to be introduced here tonight in the Clinton County Fair Queen Pageant Contest. We've been trying to get the appropriate right name. Cody is going to take me off the stage if I don't get the name right, but we'll make sure that we get that right before the end of the evening. I'm one of those kind of guys that believe everything starts better with prayer. So if you don't mind, let's just open with prayer. Father, we thank you for a beautiful day. Wow, what a great day, what a great weekend it has been here in Clinton County. We're thankful, Lord, for the opportunity to be here in a free country and a free community. We're thankful, Lord, that we can celebrate these achievements of these young ladies that have, Lord, served our community and their families. They've worked hard to get to where they are, and now, Lord, the fruits of their labor are on this stage. And regardless of what happens tonight, they are all winners because of, Lord, what they have done and the commitment that they have made. We pray a blessing upon them, upon their families. We thank you for all of the ones that have gathered here tonight to celebrate this contest. And we ask that you guide and direct us on this Father's Day weekend. Bless the fathers that they would have a great day tomorrow. In Christ's name we pray, amen. Well, thank you very much. As we get started here this evening, I wanted to introduce our last year's queen, Miss Lindsay Eisenhower. She was the 2015 Miss Clinton County 4-H Fair Queen, and she is looking stunning tonight. So if you'll give her a hand this evening. Lindsay is going to be helping us out through this evening, and then of course she'll be giving the tiara, the crown, in just a little bit, Lindsay, so we look forward to that. But she has done a great job representing Clinton County this year, and we are very proud of Lindsay and what she has accomplished. Well, it's time now for you to get the first look of our contestants, and I'm going to ask all of our ladies, they're in their business formal wear right now, and they're going to come out on the stage, and they're going to be actually introducing themselves here in just a moment. But let's get our first look tonight of our contestants, the 2016 Miss Clinton County 4-H Fair Queen contestants. Give them a hand. And they're looking beautiful, and they're only going to get better. It only gets better. It's going to be great tonight. So I want to introduce one of our contestants. She's actually contestant number two, but she is going to start the ball rolling with our contestants introducing themselves, which I think is a great twist in our new year. And I'd like to introduce Miss Whitney Ridenour. Whitney?
Hi, I'm Whitney Ridenour, and I'm introducing Izzy Ward. She just graduated from Frankfort High School and is planning to attend Purdue University in the fall. She's sponsored by Wesley Manor. Give it up for Izzy.
Good evening, everyone. I'm McKenna Eldridge, and tonight I have the pleasure of introducing contestant number two, Whitney Ridenour. Whitney is a graduate of Clinton Central High School and will be attending Purdue University in the fall. She is sponsored by Ridenour & Sons Excavating.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Miranda Robertson, and I will be introducing contestant number three, Miss McKenna Eldridge. McKenna just recently graduated from Frankfort High School and will be attending the University of Findlay in the fall, and her sponsor for tonight is the Frankfort Animal Hospital.
Good Good evening. My name is Kaylee Pletch, and it is my privilege to introduce my good friend, contestant number 4, Miranda Robertson. Miranda graduated from Clinton Prairie and will be attending IU Bloomington in the fall. She is sponsored by Bowen Family Farms.
Good evening. My name is Haley Neiman, and it brings me pleasure to introduce Ms. Kaylee Pletch, contestant number 5. Kaylee is a graduate of Clinton Prairie High School, and she will be attending Butler University in the fall. Kaylee's sponsor tonight is the Jackson Willing Workers 4-H Club.
Hello everyone, I'm Isabel Ward, and I have the pleasure of introducing contestant number 6, Haley Neiman. Haley is a graduate of Clinton Central High School and will be attending Butler University in the fall. Please give it up for Haley Neiman.
Great job, ladies, and I tell you, they are dressed for success. Wouldn't you agree? I would imagine walking into any office, any business, any company, they will be well received. Well, they're going to take a few moments now and change into their evening gowns, and they'll be coming back in just a moment to share with you in that competition. We're going to learn a little bit more about them during that time, and it gives the opportunity for the judges to see them in their evening gown. But do we want to bring them back one more time in their business wear? Do we want to do that? Yeah, let's do that. Girls, can we do that? Maybe we're going to. Oh, it's too late. Sorry. I shouldn't have looked. No, I'm just joking. It's okay. They're all right. They're way behind the door, but we'll catch them in their evening gown. Before we go any further, though, without these three folks, we wouldn't be able to have a contest, because in a contest you have to have judges. So we greatly appreciate these three ladies that have taken out of their busy schedule on Father's Day weekend. Did you get your dads and husbands and all taken care of before tonight? I hope so, speaking from a dad and a grandpa. So I want to introduce first Cassie Dalton. Cassie is a graduate of Benton Central. Cassie earned her bachelor's degree in elementary education and early childhood education from St. Joseph's College in Rensselaer, where she graduated with honors. Continuing her education, Cassie completed a master's program at Indiana State University in special education and mild interventions. She has taught at Benton Central for 13 years as a special education teacher for grades 7 through 9 and coached junior varsity and middle school volleyball for several years. A lifelong resident of Benton County, Cassie has been married to her high school sweetheart for 14 years. They have 3 children, Alexis, age 6, Eli, age 3, and Kirsten, 1 year old. Cassie has been a part of the Benton County Queen Committee for almost 10 years and is currently serving as director. She holds the title of Miss Benton County 1999 and was a 10-year 4-H member. On her free time, Cassie enjoys spending time with her family and riding horses. Would you please welcome Miss Cassie Dalton? Our next judge also comes from Benton County. It's Barb Butler. She was born and raised in Benton County. She graduated from Benton Central High School. She has been married to her husband, Steve, for 38 years. They have two daughters, Stephanie and Betsy, and one son, Brad. They participated in Benton County 4-H for many years, entering projects ranging from clothing, foods, baskets, and showing pigs. Barb and her husband own and operate Butler Meats and Catering in Lafayette for the past 27 years. She is a member of the Benton County Fair Board and was director of the Queen Pageant for 9 years. Her passion for pageant judging started after her daughter Betsy was named Miss Benton County in 2003. She is now a member of the pageant committee and has judged several county fair queen pageants, including ours tonight, over the last 13 years. Would you please welcome Miss Barb Butler? Our next judge is Molly Drummond. She and her husband, Brent, and their two sons, Jake and Tyler, live on a small farm, I can't speak tonight, in Hamilton County. They enjoy horseback riding and camping in their spare time. She is the compliance supervisor for the Northeast Division at Vectren Gas Company. She was a 10-year 4-H member in Hamilton County, completing over 100 projects. She has been a volunteer for the Hamilton County 4-H program for the past 20 years, serving as club leader, Queen Pageant Committee, on the Queen Pageant Committee, Swine Project, and 4-H Council. She is currently serving as the director for the Hamilton County 4-H Queen Pageant and has done this for the last 14 years. She also enjoys volunteer at Muncie Habitat for Humanity and Hamilton County United Way. Once again, please give it up for Miss Molly Drummond. Thank you very much, Molly. So let me ask you, judges, was this a tough decision tonight? When and you haven't even made it, but you already have interviewed these girls. It's pretty tough. I can tell you, in my years of emceeing, it's one of the toughest ones, I believe, that we've seen. So congratulations to all the young ladies. And again, thank you, judges, for helping us out this evening. Those people that we always call upon when we do things in our community, our local businesses and community leaders who always help us and come through for us in programs like this, would not happen without their help and their support, are our 2016 pageant sponsors. And I want to share with you those sponsors, and I'm going to ask that you would support these businesses if all possible. The next time you need something, we certainly would ask that you would give them at least a shot. The 2016 pageant sponsors for this year: Encompass Credit Union, Subway, The Red Raccoon, Pizza Hut, Shine 99 WILO, Del Real Auto, and by the way, Del Real will be donating the car for the Queen and her court to be using for the week of the fair pageant. So we appreciate Tony doing that. Nikki Julian, Stinson Farm, Walmart, Ellis Jewelers, Arnie's, Bruno's Pizzeria, Co-Alliance Energy, Brenda Crafton, Dairy Queen, Rural King, Hawaiian Shaved Ice, Booker's Bar and Grill, Heather's Flowers, Cody Miller Photography, George Ponton Attorney at Law, Pepe's of Frankfort, Purdue Clinton County Extension, Shoop's Country Foods, Zachary's Confections, Ashley Coleman 31 Gifts, Marissa Klez Mary Kay Cosmetics, Bethany Purley Premier Jewelry, Frankfort Bottle Gas, Senator Bran Hirschman District 7, and Nikki Bollinger, Rodan and Fields. So if you could please thank them with an applause, we would greatly appreciate that. And again, I would ask that you would thank them with your pocketbook by using the services that they offer. And we certainly, again, appreciate all of our fine sponsors. We also want to recognize, I didn't get the list, but I think we have some past royalty here tonight, some past fair queens. Do we have those in the audience? Any past fair queen in the audience tonight? All right, we've got one, two. I knew we had two, three, four. All right. Before we give them, I tell you what, let's go right here and just introduce yourself. We want everybody to know you. So, what? And tell us. No, don't tell us what year. We don't want to do that. All right. Okay. All right, Kelsey and Bailey and anybody else. Oh, we've got a little Boone County miss, right? Ellie Eisenhower, the sister of Lindsay, and she has to stand up on a chair, but she's doing well. Give her a big round of applause. Miss Little Boone County, Fair Queen. All right, well, I think that does it for all, but we thank you for being here tonight. We greatly appreciate your support of the 2016 Fair Queen pageant contest. Are we ready? Are we good? I'm getting the green light from, I stretched it long enough, so we've got the green light. So we're going to begin now in the evening gown competition, and we'll go right down the list as we have them as far as their applications. So we're going to start with Isabel Grace Ward. Isabel is a 18-year-old Frankfort, I don't want to make you any older than you should be, 18-year-old Frankfort High School graduate, and is sponsored this evening by Wesley Manor. Izzy, as her friends call her, loves pizza, and her favorite color is lavender. Isabel is very active in Latino culture, kickboxing, yoga, exercising, encouraging others, psychology, and bike riding. You sweat a lot, I think. One of her proudest moments and a big surprise is when she competed in a state health contest and was selected to be a part of the National HOSA team, which is an organization dedicated to health and wellness. Izzy has not been without those moments, though. She says she learned a good lesson in humility recently when she was babysitting a little girl at a ball game and while walking up the bleachers, slipped and went under the bleachers. Everyone was okay, with the exception of Izzy's bruised arm and maybe her pride. No bruises tonight and certainly no falls. Isabel owes her attitude and love for life to her parents for teaching her to be open-minded and love all people. Isabel plans on becoming an occupational therapist and will be attending Purdue University this fall, studying applied exercise and health. Please recognize Miss Isabel Ward. Our next contestant is Whitney Nicole Ridenour. Whitney is 18 years of age and recently graduated from Clinton Central High School, and she is sponsored by Ridenour & Sons Excavating. Whitney is a 10-year 4-H member of the Kirkland Hoosiers and has participated in sheep, swine, and junior leaders. Whitney has also been involved with the FFA and was a member of the meat judging team. Whitney enjoys the outdoors and volunteers at the Humane Society regularly. Whitney also enjoyed playing volleyball for the Lady Bulldogs for 4 seasons and was National Honor Society and an athletic scholar. Her favorite color is teal because it reminds her of the ocean. Upon earning her driver's license not too long ago, though, she had a funny moment. In all of the excitement in taking that official state picture, she ended up holding her driver's license upside down on the picture. At least her smile was right side up, just as it is tonight. Whitney has been influenced greatly by her parents as well and appreciates especially her mom's example of patience. She is reminded from her mom to stay calm and always take a second look. Maybe that driver's license, you should have done that. Whitney loves animals and will be studying wildlife biology at Purdue University. Please recognize Miss Whitney Ridenour. McKenna Rose Eldridge is our next contestant. McKenna is an 18-year-old Frankfort High School graduate. She, like Whitney, loves animals and currently works at the Frankfort Animal Hospital, which she is also her sponsor this evening. McKenna has been a part of several clubs and organizations, including National Honor Society, Zonta, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and graduated as class president. McKenna also enjoys sports and participated in volleyball. basketball, and track, winning letters in each. Although she would tell you that she never really excelled in sports, one of the highlights for her career just happened her senior year when her 4x8 relay team won in conference. McKenna is still running because of her busy schedule. However, she will make time for her favorite food, and that would be tacos at Los Tres Hermanos in Frankfurt. She recently was checking out the competition, and her cover was almost blown. And here's what happened. She went into the Taco Bell drive-thru. Shame, shame on you, McKenna. And her horn got stuck. It was pretty embarrassing as the poor guy was trying to get the order over her loud horn. Maybe you should just stick to your hometown favorite and just keep going over to Los Tres Hermanos. The people that have most influenced her life has not been the taco folks. It have been her parents and teaching her love and to love everything. Maybe this is why she is so passionate about animals. McKenna will be attending the University of Findlay, majoring in animal science. Please recognize Miss McKenna Eldridge. Our next contestant is Miranda Lee Robertson. Miranda is an 18-year-old Clinton Prairie graduate and is sponsored this evening by the Bowen Family Farms. Miranda is a 10-year 4-H member with the Perry Township Club. Her activities include Junior Leaders, Z Club, Key Club, where she is president, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, Science Club, Coach Kids Volunteer, and also volunteers at the Jacob's Ladder Food Pantry. Miranda is also a Kiwanis Club Gold Scholarship recipient. Miranda's favorite color is green, and her favorite food, which I was very proud of her, is her dad's biscuit and gravy. Sounds good right about now. She recently had a big surprise when she found out that she was selected to be a delegate at a national leadership conference in Michigan. Another kind of funny surprise that Miranda shared with us last night. After a week-long camping trip where she was stuck in the woods exploring and not having any access to showers, she was able to get to a hotel just in time to get in the room and let the rest of the family go and get a bite to eat. And she got into this hot shower and it felt so good, she said. But after several minutes, you can imagine the steam starting to build, and you guessed it, the fire alarm went off in the hotel. Way to go, Miranda. I think she was wishing she was back in the woods, but she survived and everybody lived. Miranda loves to help people, something she says she has learned from her parents. Serve people and always be willing to forgive are the lessons she has taken from them. Another lesson, Miranda, you might want to consider is to use more cold water, okay? Miranda will be attending Indiana University in the fall studying psychology. Please recognize Miss Miranda Robertson. Our fifth contestant is Kaylee Renee Pledge. Kaylee is a 19-year-old Clinton Prairie graduate where she was awarded class valedictorian and also class president. Kaylee is sponsored by the Jackson Willing Workers. She is a 10-year 4-H member and has been part of several clubs and organizations, including Key Club, Z Club, Science Club, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and many more. She also played volleyball and basketball and was a scholar athlete. One of her shining moments was being named valedictorian because the competition was so close that four other students, all within 18 thousandths of a point, were competing. And congratulations to Kaylee. Kaylee is not only beautiful and smart, but she has another distinction that few know about until now. And I'm going to share that secret. She can also be gross. Yes, you heard me. Gross. Once after a basketball practice, she had enough of that mouthpiece that she had in her mouth because she had just received braces and the mouthpiece was bothering her. And so she took the mouthpiece out. And as she did, she was standing right next to her coach and she just handed the mouthpiece right to her coach and put it in his hand with this big, long string of saliva out of the mouthpiece. You can imagine the embarrassment that she had, but I think the coach took it in stride. We have We have warned Kaylee tonight, though, that she simply needs to smile and keep everything in her mouth. The people she most admires is her parents for always being there and supporting her. She always knows wherever she goes, whatever she does, she can look into the audience and see her parents. Kaylee is interested in pediatric pharmacy and is planning on attending Butler University this fall. Please recognize Ms. Kaylee Pledge. And last but certainly not least, Ms. Haley June Neiman. Haley is an 18-year-old Clinton Central graduate and also a 10-year 4-H member with her club, the Kirkland Hoosiers, being her sponsor this evening. She is currently the vice president of the club and was formerly secretary. She has been involved in cake decorating, foreign language club, National Honor Society, and serves on the youth council. Haley is an active volunteer in our community and has served organizations such as Coach Kids, Wesley Manor, and she helped serve the annual Thanksgiving dinner the last 3 years in our community. She's also always hoping that one day they'll allow her to serve her favorite food, chocolate peanut butter ice cream. That sounds good to me. I'll pass on the turkey and take that. Haley is also an athlete and enjoys swimming. One of her memorable moments came recently when she just edged out, literally by a finger, her competition in the last leg of her last relay to win. If she is not swimming or volunteering, she is working for a local landscape company. Haley has a bright future in front of her and many open doors, with the exception of one, and let me explain. While at work the other day, she was given the assignment to pick up some items in a storage barn that the owner told her that they needed. She said that the door's tricky, Haley, so be careful. Haley kept jiggling and wiggling, and the darn key just wouldn't open till finally, after having enough, she turned it and broke the key in the lock. Well, the good news is that they did get the door open, and the better news is that Haley still has her job, so we're thankful for that. The doors are going to be swinging open for this young lady this fall at Butler University, where she is planning on attending. Undecided on a major at this time, the key for Haley is helping others and making people happy. She has learned that from her parents, who have given her many keys to success in encouraging her and allowing her to be the person she is, seeing different perspectives from all of their travels. Please recognize Miss Haley Neiman. Okay, now is all that important time where the girls, I think this is probably the time the girls have been the most nervous about. So you guys just chill, don't make them feel nervous, don't, you know, bear down on them. This is the impromptu questioning time of the program. And so let me explain what's going to happen. I'm going to hand the bowl over here to our reigning queen in just a moment. And Lindsay is going to allow the young ladies to pick a question. There are 15 questions. Oh, the girls have no idea what question they're going to pick, but they're going to have to answer it for you tonight. So Lindsay is going to hand me the question, and I will read it for so all you can hear, and then the ladies will answer the question. So Lindsay, if you can help me out. So we'll begin with our first contestant, Isabel. Izzy, if you could come to the microphone, please. I'm going to say there's no way you can cheat because this thing is so folded. Let me ask the question, make sure I can read it first. How do you feel that social media has impacted your generation?
I feel that social media has, contrary to the popular perception that it's a negative influence, I think that it's a positive influence. It's provided connection through connecting with people who have the same beliefs and same situations going on, and it provides a support system. So I think that it's actually a positive aspect. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Isabel. And I'll make sure I post that on Facebook tonight, so when I get home. Okay, our next contestant is Whitney Nicole Ridenour. Whitney.
Oh,
Okay, Whitney, you've got a long one. What do you feel is the biggest obstacle facing your generation, and what have you done or how do you plan to overcome it?
I feel like the biggest obstacle facing our generation is technology and it advancing, and we have to work with it and keep developing our skills when the technology keeps moving forward. We have to move forward with it so we know how to use it in the future. So my generation and the older generations have to use the new technology being developed, so all generations really need to build their skills in learning the technology. So,
awesome.
Yeah,
thank you. All right, thank you very much, Whitney. Thank you very much, Whitney Ridenour. And I noticed that Whitney, as soon as she says old generation, she pointed to me. I don't think you should dock her for anything like that, but anyway. All right, our next contestant is McKenna Rose Eldridge. McKenna. All right, McKenna, why would you like to be selected as the next 2016 Clinton County and 4-H Fair Queen?
I would like to be selected as Fair Queen because this county has molded and shaped me into the type of person I am today, and I feel as if it's my responsibility to give back in a positive way. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, McKenna. Our next contestant is Miranda Lee Robertson. Miranda. An appropriate question for you, Miranda. What have you done to help a group or community in your county?
I have been involved in Junior Leaders since I was in seventh grade. And through Junior Leaders, we host many 4-H days and Clover Bud days, which we basically just encourage young kids in the community to come out and learn more about 4-H and encourage them to join once they are able to fit the age requirements. And then we also do landscaping around the 4-H building and the extension office. So I feel like I have greatly impacted the 4-H community. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Miranda. And Miranda has had such discipline tonight because I would be wanting to grab that mic and just shove it right down in front of my face. But she was told, don't touch it, and she's done a great job of that tonight. So, but she's been on her tippy toes, that's for sure. Our next contestant, our fifth contestant, is Kaylee Renee Pledge. Kaylee. All right, Kaylee, if I had extra time in Clinton County and asked you to show me around, where would you take me and why?
First, I would take you to Downtown Diner, which is a local restaurant because they have the best breakfast and lunch that I've ever had. And then I would take you to Stony Heights, which is a castle-looking house over by the TPA Park, and let you listen to the history of the house because it really is fascinating. It involves ghosts and death, and it's very interesting. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Anything with ghost and death, count me in. I'm going. I'm on my way. All right, our final contestant this evening, Haley June Neiman. Haley. All right, Haley, what was one of the top news stories in your county this week?
One of the top news stories in our county this week involved a meeting concerning the wind turbines that may possibly be going up in our county. And there have been some changes made to the idea. And I personally think they would be great and that it's very important that we find new energy sources that can help us continue in our future. So. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much, Haley. And that was, by the way, the most dreaded question that any of them were they did not want that question. And I can guarantee you they were all, but Haley, you did a great job. Thank you very much. In fact, we talked about that last night. Can we take that question out? Sorry, Russ, with Clinton County Daily News here, you would think, but, you know, there's other things in the world like Downtown Diner and Stony Heights we got to go to. So, all right, we have gone through the competition here this evening as far as the business formal and the evening gowns. I think let's bring out, can we bring out the girls one more time? Let's do that now. Is that okay? Can we do that now? Bring out the girls one more time. Let you get a good look at them. All of our evening gowns. Aren't they beautiful? I mean, my goodness. Gorgeous, gorgeous gals. Fantastic. And what's your name? Yes, your name.
Adam.
Adam? Yeah. I haven't had a chance to meet you, Adam, but I hear you're Betty's grandson.
Yep.
Is that the case?
Yeah.
Adam has the best. Adam, step out on the out here on the stage. Adam has the best job of the night, okay? Adam has had the distinct pleasure of making sure those girls get down those steps, all right? So we're very glad that Adam's here. When I told him that a while ago, he looked at me and shrugged his shoulders. I told John, he's not old enough yet, all right? But he will. One of these days, you'll realize how special of a job you had. So thank you very much. Ladies, go back to your area right now. We'll dismiss you, and then we'll call you back out in just a little bit. One more time, give him a hand. Okay, I do not envy your task. I mean, these are some great gals, so we're going to dismiss you as judges now. They're going to go over here into our illustrious green room, which is the kitchen. I don't know if there's any biscuits and gravy or anything like that, but help yourself to whatever's in there. And we're going to take a quick break. The ladies are going to go make their decision. We're going to take a quick break. We have to do a couple of interviews for WILO and Shine 99 TV. So help yourself to the restroom and take a deep breath and enjoy some fellowship, all right? John, we're here at the Queen Contest. It's coming up on the fair just around the corner. You're the president. What can we expect and anticipate in this year's fair?
Well, there's going to be a lot of different things going on. We've added some different events from what we usually do during the week of the fair. We brought back harness racing for one. We've got this all-weather track. We want to make sure that we use it. So Tuesday and Wednesday, there'll be harness racing out here. Thursday, we're going to have a truck tractor pull. Friday night is the Corey Cox concert. And then Saturday the 16th, the last day of the fair, will actually be a demolition derby to cap it off. During the weekend, most people are used to it by now. When we start out the first night, Saturday the 9th, we're going to do a fish fry this year. Dan's Fish Fry is going to come in, and then we're going to have a demolition derby right after that. So the fish fry is from 4 to 7, and then the derby will start at 7, so give people an opportunity to come out here, see some of the stuff that's coming in, because the fair carnival will be coming in over the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, and then they should be ready to rock and roll on Monday night.
Great. So it's going to be bookend by the demolition derby on Saturday and Saturday.
Yes.
But you're going to kick things off with a fish fry. Everybody loves a fish fry.
Yeah, we're so looking forward to that. We've got a great group of people that are fair board members now, and we're all coming together and gelling, and this thing's like a wild bronco, but we're all on for the long haul and long ride, and it's going to be great. I think the fair this year, people's going to really notice a difference.
Great. Well, we appreciate your commitment and service. You know, one thing, you mentioned the carnival. That's always a big thing for the kids, and that starts on Monday.
Yes, that's correct. The carnival will start off on Monday. Like I said in my opening statement, you will notice a difference with this carnival. They've got some bigger rides, something that you would see maybe at King's Island or something like that. I've seen one of the rides personally, and I'm amazed that they actually ship that thing around, because I think people are going to be really surprised when they see that one in particular, and then they've got another one. I haven't seen it, but I'm told it's just as exciting.
What's the number one reason why people should come to the Clinton County Fair this year?
The food.
Oh, yeah, always, always the food. John, thank you very much. Appreciate your service.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to now talk to, we've been talking about the fair, but now we're going to be talking about
the Queen contest, and we're actually in the presence of royalty here. Lindsay Eisenhower, our last year's winner. Lindsay, let me just ask you this. What has it meant to be the Queen of Clinton County this past year, and how do you see this evolving?
I was blessed to be crowned last year, and it's helped me grow as a person, and I really appreciate growing up in this county and being in this land and being at the 4-H Fair, and so I was really privileged to be able to get this opportunity.
Well, you've been a beautiful queen. You've done a great job. How does this impact younger ladies? Your little sister is Miss Boone County, Miss Boone County,
and she
just radiates. How does this impact young girls' lives, and how does this propel you into the future?
It really gives you, being on stage gives you a different perspective about yourself. It really gives you self-assurance and self-worth, and gives you interview practice for later, you know, job opportunities and things like that. And, you know, makes you have more friendships, and I've gotten a lot of mentors out of this that show me, you know, the grace of God every single day.
Sure,
and so.
Sure. So what's your plans?
I go to Butler University right now. I'm studying communications. I hope to do PR stuff for a sports team or maybe Riley Hospital. That would be my dream. But.
Oh, wow. I can see you out on the sidelines now. Another Aaron Andrews. So, well, congratulations.
Thank you.
And we know that you're going to do a great job in the future.
Yes, so thank you for doing this.
Hey, we've got Cody Miller, who's here. And we'll just switch sides. We don't want to lose any beauty here. Cody is with us as well. Cody, the organizer of this, first of all, thank you. Appreciate you stepping up and doing this. What a great job.
Thank you.
How has this impacted your life as far as getting involved with all these great girls?
It's actually been amazing. I wasn't in the Queen pageant when I was in 4-H. I was a proud 10-year 4-H member, but was down in the livestock barns and just had a little bit more priority there for me. But becoming back involved in this organization really means a lot to me because I want to be able to give the youth in this county the same opportunities that I had. I would go back, and several of us here that were all in 4-H together have said we'd go back and do it again in a heartbeat. So I want to give them the same great experiences and opportunities that I had.
When you look at this opportunity and you look into the future, how do you see this evolving? I mean, we have a great crowd here tonight. We have 6 contestants, but we know that could be much bigger. There's so many great gals out there. What would you tell young ladies that may be looking at this on the web as they're searching, maybe find it on YouTube, whatever the case may be? What would you tell them in Clinton County, being a resident of Clinton County, why they should get involved next year?
Not only is there opportunities for scholarships, we are offering 3 scholarships there this year instead of just 1. The Queen will receive a $1,000 scholarship donated by the Fair Board. The first runner-up will get $500, and the second runner-up is $250. So we've extended the scholarships.
So show me the money.
Yes, yes. So we believe higher education is very important, and so that's one way that we would like the girls to be involved, is to be able to extend that for their further education. And just the friendships they can make and the experiences they can gain from this, we typically try to bring in at least a couple, 1 or 2, maybe even 3, outside community members that are really proficient with public speaking and interview process, and even some modeling for them just to help get them more comfortable with that. So they can meet a lot of contacts as well in this community and in the pageant world, if that's what they're interested in.
Well, and I can tell you, looking at the girls this year, you guys have done an outstanding job. You've worked very diligently. And I think that one of the things that we were talking about with the girls last night, it helps them get out of their comfort zone. It changes the comfort level, and it helps you to grow. Would you agree with that, Lindsay?
Definitely. A lot of these girls are just graduating high school, so they may not have had a big interview session or being on stage experience, that kind of thing, and so it really does bring them out of their comfort zone.
Awesome. Any last words?
Best of luck to all of them. Like you said earlier, I do not envy the judges. It has been amazing working with these 6 ladies, and I'm excited to crown the court and get Fair Week underway.
Oh, we are too. And the Clinton County Fair is just a few weeks away.
Yeah.
The pageant is going to end here in just a few minutes, a few moments. We'll find out who will be the 2016 Fair Queen here at the Clinton County Fair. For Shine 99, I'm Shan Sheridan.
All right, thank you.
All right, very good job, Shan. I sure appreciate that. That was excellent. And again, welcome to Shine 99 TV, and you're watching the 2016 rendition of the Queen Contest. The official name is the 2016 Miss Clinton County and 4-H Fair Queen Pageant. And we do want to thank Cindy Casey Shoops for the use of their bandwidth and Wi-Fi at the 4-H building. We're taking a break now. Why? Because the judges are having to make a hard decision among the four, actual six contestants. Isabel Ward is 19, and she's sponsored by Wesley Manor Retirement Home. She's one of the contestants, Isabel Ward. Whitney Reidenauer is 18 years old and sponsored by Reidenauer Sons Excavating. McKenna Eldridge is 19 years old, sponsored by Frankfurt Animal Hospital. The fourth contestant is Miranda Robinson, and she's 19 years old, sponsored by Bowen Family Farms. Kaylee Pletch is 18 years old, sponsored by Jackson Willing Workers 4-H Club. And then Haley Neiman is 19 years old, sponsored by Kirkland Hoosiers 4-H Club. This presentation is made possible by Clinton County's Senator Brant Hirschman, and we are pausing now. It looks like the judges might be coming back, so we're going to probably hush the room. We'll hush as the envelopes are opened. It appears that the judges are filing back in now, taking their places, and it looks like Shan is getting about ready to take over at the lectern as well. We want to thank Shan Sheridan for emceeing this event, doing a nice job, and it looks like he has the envelopes now. So soon we will know who the 2016 Queen is for the 4-H and Clinton County Fair. Let's join the presentation now. Looks like he's in no hurry to get started. Looks like he does have the envelopes in his hands. Looks like we have a crowd here of 150 or so. We have not made a count, but most of the chairs are filled for the six contestants this year.
I'm going to give you the two-minute warning.
Looks like Shan Sheridan has given us a two-minute warning. We'll go over the six different contestants again. Isabel Ward is 19, and she's sponsored by Wesley Manor Retirement Home. Whitney Reidenauer is 18, sponsored by Reidenauer Sons Excavating. McKenna Eldridge is 19 and sponsored by the Frankfurt Animal Hospital. Miranda Robinson is 19 years old, sponsored by the Bowen Family Farms. Kaylee Pletch is 18, sponsored by Jackson Willing Workers 4-H Club. Haley Neiman is 19 years old, sponsored by the Kirkland Hoosiers 4-H Club. Again, this presentation on Shine99TV.com made possible by Clinton County's Senator Brant Hirschman. You could get a nice shot of all those tiaras. That's just a beautiful, beautiful couch, isn't it? Those are the tiaras and banners that are going to be given away. If you want to go ahead and zero in on the couch. And we get a close-up shot of the beautiful accessories that will accompany the ladies around the 4-H Fair here in the next few weeks. The fair starts on July the 9th, I believe, this year. July 9th through the 16th. And so these ladies will attend many of the programs and the activities throughout the 4-H Fair, and also represent the fair at Kiwanis Rotary Clubs, typically. Maybe give a presentation there. It's a good chance to be interviewed on the radio as well, and with the press. They will, I'm sure, develop some of their communication skills as they take on their responsibilities with the 4-H and Clinton County Fair. Okay.
Okay, Pam is back, so we can... reigning queen share some final thoughts and final words. And I'm going to just tell you, Lindsay and I were just talking a little bit ago, and actually Cody and I have been talking as well. And if our future has anything to do with the young people that are represented here tonight, and certainly the young lady that has represented Clinton County so well this past year. Our future is in good shape, and we certainly appreciate the service and the compassion and passion that these young ladies have demonstrated, and especially Lindsay, and being here tonight and working very diligently with these young ladies throughout this week. So, without any further ado, I'd like for you to give a very warm welcome for the last time to our Fair Queen, Clinton County 2015, Miss Lindsay Eisenhower.
Good evening, everyone. First, I would like to thank you all for coming. These ladies really appreciate it. Parents, you have raised wonderful daughters, and each one of them brings a different set of unique skills and talents to this competition. Thank you to my own parents for loving me unconditionally, giving me guidance when I am in need, but letting me make my own choices in order to grow. Thank you to the Queen Pageant sponsors for making my reign less chaotic and always full of laughable moments. I would like to thank my court last year for being three of the most genuinely unique people I know. During Fair Week, we really were all in this together. Thank you to the Fair Board and to everyone that makes Clinton County Fair happen for taking on that responsibility and being involved with making this fair run smoothly and for sending me flowers at the state competition. Thank you to everyone, to Clinton County, for making me feel so welcome and secure after being crowned and throughout my reign. Lastly, I would like to thank the Lord for instilling in me gifts that this competition has revealed in me, for providing me with strength and hope, and for simple blessings each and every day. A cliche saying that was said to me throughout high school was, "The days go by slow, but the years go by fast." And I cannot tell you how fast this year has gone by for me. It amazes me how my life, my family, my education, and my personal characteristics have evolved over this past year. Many of these areas in my life have been positively affected by my reign as Miss Clinton County, which is also why it's crazy to me to think about 3 years ago when I thought I'd never be on this stage, let alone coming back a year later to crown the next young lady. I remember sitting where you all are sitting, watching my older sister compete on the stage. As every contestant walked across the stage, I kept thinking, no way would I ever do that. Fast forward 2 years, and I'm texting my mom saying, "I think I'm going to compete in Miss Clinton County." And she ecstatically replied, "Really? When's the application due?" "Today." "Today, Lindsay." So the day of the pageant comes around, and that morning we're going through interviews, preliminaries, and having lunch with the judges. All of the contestants left the fairgrounds around noon, which meant we had about 6 hours before we had to be back for finals and before we knew who Miss Clinton County would be. I remember having moments of weakness at home and thinking I did only okay in my interview. My parents both looked at me and said, "Someone has to win. Why wouldn't or couldn't it be you?" Although I know they are biased, this changed my pessimistic and doubtful attitude into one of hope and confidence. And I deeply thought about this. Why can't it be me? And then the moment came when my name was called as Miss Clinton County 2015. As I think every queen is, I was shocked to hear my name, and it took a second for me to register what had just occurred. Being overwhelmed with gratifying emotion, I was not thinking about the long-term effect that this crowning would have on my life. It would bring me to an unexplainable amount of self-assurance and self-worth, friendships that continue to grow to this day, and mentors that set an example for me to be poised, gracious, and deeply beautiful. And then the week the 4-H'ers wait for all year was finally here. It was Fair Week. I learned quickly that among many things, I took sleep, healthy food, and simple downtime for granted. During this week, I was awake at the crack of dawn daily. I smiled from ear to ear 24/7. I was caught stranded under the grandstands during a huge thunderstorm. And just a side note, when it's torrential downpouring, it's every man for themselves. No one cares if you're wearing a crown and a sash at that point. With this being said, I wouldn't trade Fair Week for anything. I'm grateful that this past year, I received the honor to reward the 4-H'ers with banners and ribbons displaying their hard work, promote the fair in ways I wouldn't otherwise have the opportunity, and take pictures and answer questions from little girls and boys that believed I was royalty. One of the sweetest moments I had at the fair was when one little girl ran up behind me, wrapped her arms around my leg, and joyfully said, "Princess!" There were strange and humorous moments too, however, like when one little boy asked me, "Why are you so dirty? You're a princess." I just laughed and hugged him, which was definitely my mistake because he did not want to be hugged by a dirty princess. This week definitely would not have been the same without my court, however. It would not have been as enjoyable if Emily Savins didn't scream at the top of her lungs when a llama tried to escape from the show ring, or if Emma Tully didn't slip and almost fall into the mud in the infield, or if we didn't find out that Andrea Dickerson could sing when she sang the national anthem on the spot in a grandstand event. And I'm not sure we would have survived without Milky Way runs during the day in the Stang. Fair time is a very special time of year, and I am so glad that I was able to participate in it in such a special way. Moving forward, if I thought I was out of my comfort zone in the county pageant, I can't even explain to you how anxious I was about the state competition. However, I was soon to learn that this was going to be one of the best experiences of my life. Through my 3 days at the pageant, I found that if you are truly beautiful on the inside, it will shine through to the outside. If you are completely genuine, warm-hearted, well-rounded, a good listener to others, humble, and have faith in yourself and our Father, then I believe that your smile, your skin, and the way you carry yourself will be illuminated on stage and off. I was so blessed to share a room, meals, and a stage with such incredible women. And congratulations to your new Miss Indiana State Fair, Tate Fritchley. The judges picked an amazing young woman. Back to what I realized the day of my county pageant. I think about this with every opportunity that arises in my life now. Whether that's getting a spot on a team, or getting an internship, or anything else, these days, the world is filled with competition. Someone has to get it. Why can't it be me, or any of you? Every reason that you can think of for it not to be you is a self-created excuse. I'm sure there are double that many reasons why it should be you. 3 years ago, I didn't want to do this pageant because I didn't like dresses, speaking on a stage. I changed my cleats to basketball shoes from one season to the next. But those were just excuses that came from fear. If you make a decision based on fear, like my once decision to not do the pageant, you might miss out on something that would change your life, that would inspire yourself, that would inspire others, that would help you become the person you've been longing to be. That's exactly what my year of rain did for me. I didn't plan on this. So for the young ladies in the audience that consider yourselves tomboys or cowgirls, or just deep down are afraid of this experience, you can do it, and you will become a more well-rounded person because of it. These next few moments will be bittersweet for me, but I'm excited for someone else to be excited about it. This group of young ladies makes it easy for me to hand down the crown, because they are all great candidates to represent our county. I am so proud of them and the ways that they have grown throughout our meetings this year. These young ladies surprised me with their compassion for the other contestants, ability to overcome their nerves, their upbeat attitudes, and their overall unique personalities. It was truly a joy to work with them, which is why I am so honored and blessed and humbled to have the opportunity to crown the new queens. I am so incredibly grateful to have been Miss Clinton County, but the moment we've all been waiting for is coming upon us very soon. It's time now to crown Miss Clinton County 2016 in her court. Thank you.
Great job. Of course, there's a mess back there. Why do girls do this? I mean,
They're making me cry.
Oh. Okay, I'm sorry. Get composure. Before we go, though, I don't know if we've heard a better sermon tonight. What a tremendous message Lindsay brought to us. And I want to just simply tag that. Since I'm a preacher, you may not be in church tomorrow, so I'll just take the time to do it now. I totally, absolutely agree with what she said. And I want to just challenge not just the young ladies in the room, but I want to challenge the old men, the older ladies, the teenagers. You know, you have the opportunity to get out of your comfort zone every day. We have the opportunity to do something different, to do something that matters, to do something that makes an impact in someone's life each and every day, whether it be in the line at Taco Bell or whether it be representing our county at the state competition. We have opportunities to share the light that is inside us. And I'm going to just share something, and I'm going to be very bold in saying this. And I make no apologies. Our God has asked us to love and to give. There are other gods that would ask to kill and destroy. We serve a God that wants to shine light. And I pray that we can take that message that Lindsay shared with us tonight and let it be a shining example of all of our lives as we continue to live our lives. Well, the time has come. It is that moment. But before we do that, and before I bring the contestants back on stage, I have to share with you, though, what they get. It's pretty cool. All the contestants will get gift bags from all of our different sponsors. I mean, Zachary's Candy, Pizza Hut Pizza, Bruno's. I'm hungry just thinking about it. I don't know about biscuits and gravy from Miranda's dad, but maybe, I don't know. The second runner-up will get a $250 scholarship. The first runner-up will get a $500 scholarship. And, of course, the winner will get a $1,000 scholarship. And, of course, they will have the opportunity to drive around in that Tony Del Real Auto Group car. So it's going to be a lot of fun come fair week. So having said that, we're going to bring all of our ladies back on the stage. Hopefully their makeup is, I've given you enough time to get your makeup back together and no mascara is running. So girls, if you can make your way back up on the stage. I hear clunking. There we go. All right. There we go. Yeah, give them a round of applause. They deserve it. They certainly deserve it. Okay, now where, oh, yeah, I did put it in here. Okay. I don't want to do a Steve Harvey. Okay, I'll try not to do that. Okay, so we'll go down with Miss Congeniality first, and I'll share that winner, and then we're going to go second, first, and then the queen. So here we go. Miss Congeniality tonight is being crowned as Isabel Ward. So congratulations, Isabel, Miss Congeniality. What a beautiful smile. All right. We'll let the sashes be put on and we'll take care. My first year doing this, I hurried everything and the poor girls were trying to, I just kept pushing and I will not do that. Are you good? We're good? All right. All right. Our second runner-up is contestant number 5, Kaylee Pledge. You need a stool, Lindsay? Maybe, I don't know. She did ask all the ladies to make sure they bend as much as they could, so great job. Our first runner-up is contestant number 4, Miranda Robertson.
We didn't practice this part.
They tell me that I had to draw this out, but it's after 8 o'clock and everybody's hungry, so we're gonna move forward. The Queen for 2016, the Clinton County 4-H Fair Queen for 2016, McKenna Eldridge. And I don't think we have a, there she is. I don't think we have that, but we've got some more music. But McKenna's going to have a walk here, and we're going to let her take a moment to greet all of her beautiful, beautiful other contestants. That was the cue, McKenna, to greet those other beautiful contestants and love on them a little bit. I will tell you, folks, no cliche here, not making this up. One of the closest races. These are great young ladies. We have a great future ahead when we've got them leading us. I'd like to give them one more big round of applause, if you would. Get out there and make it a great day. God bless you. Have a great night. Drive safely and come to the Clinton County Fair. It's coming up.